students, now today I am going to discuss about the complex integration. This is the first year engineering course and it is very popular topic. You know the complex is one of the favorite branch of any student. If you talk about the complex integration, let us consider a continuous function fz defined at all points of this curve. Just to look this curve, you have already gone through in vector calculus the line integration. And in the similar pattern, if you subdivide this curve C into the small subdivision, say that this curve has two vertices, that is A and B, at the points, points has been taken P naught, Pi minus 1, Pi up to Pn, then and you want to discuss the arcual length and to discuss the summation as a whole, we have to consider this arc. That is pi minus 1 to pi. It means on the arc pi minus 1 to pi, the limit of the sum may be defined. That is already in the calculus, well known term. The iota is equal to 1 to n f of xi I del z I. Del z I is already defined here. What is del z I? Z I minus 1. And del this xi I is any point on the curve. Then this, of course, this when n tends to infinity, then you may consider that this is in a such a way when del z I is tends to 0. What does it mean? It means the points on this curve that should be in the neighborhood. It means their length, their arcual length should be very, very less. That indicates here in, as a limiting point even del z I tends to 0. This is called line integral. As I said, it is already discussed into the vector calculus part. And here in this complex integration, the same, in the similar manner, you can define if this integration fz dz under the closed curve C, where this fz taken along the curve C. So this is known as complex integration, and in some book, it is also called as the contour also. So it means if you go in the numerical part of the complex integration, then you will find this C, Fz, Dz, how it will be evaluated for different kind of the function. Then here, as we have already discussed in the first lecture, you know Fz is u plus iota v, right? Dz, similarly dz is dx plus iota dy. Then c fz dz, this may be defined very easily. You can multiply here. You look here fz and dz. So fz is what? U plus iota v, and dz is what? Dx plus iota dy. If you multiply both the term u plus iota v and dx plus iota dy, then of course you will get from here you will get this equation. So this equation you can derive very easily from here. The u dx minus v dy plus iota times v dx plus u dy. But just to mind it, because this is very important step for the calculation point of view, for numerical point of view. Why? If this evaluation of line integral of a complex function can be reduced to the evaluation of two line integrals. And a complex definite integral is called a complex line integral. So this you have always remember in your mind, then there will be no place of any confusion. A complex definite integral is called a complex line integral. So this is in this form you can evaluate the integral. How it is shown here. As I said, sometimes some authors and in many places in the books, this is called also a contour. So this how we can define the contour, just to look. A contour is a piecewise a smooth path consisting of finite numbers of smooth arcs. Okay? Joined end to end, and an arc is given by an equation as discussed there. Wahan par jaise bataya gaya, the, in the same manner, if you are considering any parametric form, then zt may be written as xt plus iota yt, and subject to t must be length between a and b.
So what is the property? The same manner you can discuss about the integration, and if you talk about the properties of contour, this is very important again for the numerical, just to solution of the numerical problem, just to look the first property. What first property say? First property say that under the closed curve C, z dot fz dz, this is equal to z naught outside and C fz dz. Here, the z naught is a complex constant. As we know, what is the complex number? Actually, the order pair of real number is called complex number. It means, if you write z is equal to x plus iota y, I discuss, then you always understood the points. Z naught represent, any single point, that may be x naught plus iota y naught, and this symbolically represent any number, 1, 2, 3, it means any number like 1 plus twice iota, that is a complex, constant. So here, this property say, it is z naught, when this z naught will be the complex constant, this will be outside of the integral, and the property is as it is, you can apply in during the numerical problem. Now, second property say, fz plus dz, it means the addition of two complex complex function, the integration of two complex function, then it will be divided, sum will be divided, like cfz dz plus czz dz. Third property is very important, sometimes it is written under the closed curve C, if the negative sign is there, like this, so minus C under the integration fz dz, then this will reflected here, the minus, whole the integration sign will change, so minus under the integration C fz dz. And the fourth property is also very important, usually we apply this property during the numerical computation, is C fz dz is equal to nothing but C1 fz dz plus C2 fz dz, and where this C1 and C2 is what? C1 and C2 are the two parts, two different parts, you can say, if we can divide the C, we can broke the broken, C is broken under the two parts, that is C1 and C2. Now, the coming on numerical, how you can solve the numerical problem, let us suppose one numerical I have taken here, to make your procedure easier, your understanding easy, how you calculate, evaluate this integration, where fz is given, that is y minus x minus iota 3x square, of course this is the real part and that is the imaginary part, it means what is the real part, y minus x, and then 3x square is imaginary part. Now the question is, if from 0 to 0 to a 1 0 and to b 1 1, and second is y is equal to x, you look the this curve, this is the line y is equal to 0, okay, and this is the point is given, that is 1 0, so this is the point 1 0, let us suppose a is the point 1 0, this is the point, this is also given 1 1, so b is 1 1, and for the second portion, if you attach this OB, then this is y is equal to x, this is nothing but y is equal to x, it means first of all you will broke this fz dz into the two parts, that is c fz dz is equal to a long OA fz dz and plus a long AB fz dz. Now our target will be, we have to solve separately along the OA, what is the evaluation of integral, and then along AB, what is the evaluation of integral. It is very easy to see, on OA, just you look on OA, y at 0, y is equal to 0, and z, of course you know x plus iota y, then just you put the y is equal to 0 here, then you will get dz is equal to dx, and it means, again you go fz, from here, so from here you can write, after putting y is equal to 0 there, fz is minus x minus iota 3x square. In this case, oafz dz is equal to 0 to 1 along 0 to 1, this is the point, the along 0 to 1 minus x minus iota 3x square dx. On simplification, this is I am leaving for you, on simplification you will get minus half minus iota along OA. The value of integration OA along OA will be minus half minus iota. Now similarly, along AB, just to look along AB, then you will find this is in between 1, 1, 0 and 1. This is in between 0 and 1. This is the line. Okay? This is the line 0 to 1. So this is in between 0 to 1 and y minus 1. Z is of course 1 plus iota y because x is equal to 1 and dz is iota dy and y is varies from 0 to 1. Then under integration this, you will get this. This function minus iota y 2 plus 1 by 3 and after this adding both, you will get this value here. Along the curve C, fz dz you will get 5 minus 3 iota divided by 2. If you talk about the second part of the problem, then now it becomes very easy. Just to look here, I have calculated in corner. At y is equal to x, C fz dz, of course, after putting the y is equal to x in, here, you look, this value will be terminated. Because y is equal to x, x minus x, only you will get here minus iota 3x square. So minus iota 3x square in bracket 1 plus iota, then dx under the integration, you will get 1 minus iota. So in this way, this is a kind of problem which can be evaluated very easily with the help of diagram. First of all, you have to sketch the curve and then along as per broken of the curve, as per requirement, you can solve the problem easily. Now next, this is the problem assignment for all the students. You just to go through and evaluate the similar problem, z square dz on the similar pattern where c is the arc from A11 to B24 along y is equal to x square, that is your well-known parabola, and y is equal to 3x minus 2, that is line. So you have to do, in addition, any 5 problem from any book which you have with you, you have to attempt an assignment problem on the same topic. Now, moving forward the syllabus, here I wish to discuss, since we have to discuss as per Aristotle is concerned, the Cauchy integration, and before the Cauchy integration, I would like to discuss about the simply connected and multiple connected domains. What is the meaning of simply connected and multiple connected? So just to look, a domain D in the complex plane is called simply connected. In the complex plane is called simply connected if every simple closed curve which lies in D can be shrunk to a point without leaving D, without leaving that domain. Okay? For example, it will be very clear to you. A interior of a circle and ellipse are simply connected domain. Like this. Just to look the first figure here. It is very clear because this resemble the definition part of simply connected domain. This is simply connected, the example of simply connected domain. But if you look the last two figure, this and this, then this comply the definition a domain D is not simply connected, is called multiple connected. So this is called multiple connected. But this figure, if you will work on this figure, then this is called, initially the figure was multiple connected, but it is converted into simple connected. So initially this figure was multiple connected, but now it look like simple connected domain. So this is one of the important part which is required to discuss prior to this Cauchy integral theorem. So in the next lecture, I will discuss about the Cauchy integral theorem, and I will inform and upload here this my lecture.